Hi. Welcome. Let's come and sit. Sit in a shape that's called Sukhasana. Right shin in front of the left. And see if you can get your heels underneath your knees. And we'll just sit here for a little second. Yep. Now, take the heels of your hands to the tops of the thighs. And with the heels of the hands at the top of the thighs, just gently depress the top of the thighs. And as you do, just rock side to side a little bit. Become aware of the baby toe sides of the feet. Become aware of your butt. And then just pause there. Slide the hands forward to your mid-thighs and think about externally rotating them. And this time, not pushing them down, but almost raking them out. So you're trying to slide the thighs out towards the front of the room. And still, rock side to side just a little bit. Hollow the belly a little. Float the ribs off the waist. Become aware of your lowest rear ribs and imagine that they fan or wing out into the thighs. Now take the heels of the hands to the very top of the knee and depress the knee down and forward and push your upper body up and back. And pause there for a little second. Tailbone descends, the breastbone ascends, and the birdcage of the ribs floats on the water of the belly. Now take the back of the left hand and float it just above the navel. And take the back of the right, put it in the palm of the left, and let the thumbs gently touch. Now this is more about breath awareness. You don't have to change anything. Allegedly, the highest seat we can take is that of observation. So all we're going to do is observe the four parts of the breath. There's a gentle inhalation and a pause, an exhalation and a pause. And as we sit here with the body online and directing our mind towards the breath, we're just going to watch our breathing, and we'll do that for about a minute. When the mind wanders, bring it back to the breath, as you would kind of redirect a child. Terrific. And then just pause. Put your hands down on your knees. So we're going to come onto our back, and the nature of the instruction or the nature of the cues is to drive us into the body to become aware of specific body parts and in an effort to occupy our body, right? So ideally what's happening is we're bringing 100% of our body online, but we're only working at about 50% capacity. Yep. So we'll see how that. knees are aligned with the shoulders and the heels are aligned with the hips. Just pause there for a second. Draw the left knee in towards the chest and gently cup the knee and direct the left knee towards the left underarm. Immediately become aware of the right heel, make the right heel heavy, direct the right knee to the ceiling, and broaden your lower back. Try not to squeeze out the lower back, but make the sacrum heavy. Put the left foot on the floor, anchor the left heel to the earth, point the left knee to the ceiling, draw the right knee into the chest, and direct the right knee towards the right underarm. Become aware of the lower back, but try not to flatten it out. Instead, depress the tailbone, see if you can find a gentle uplift in the lumbar spine. And be patient, breathe easy, as if you were sleeping. Put that foot on the floor. Anchor the right heel, point the right knee at the ceiling, draw the left knee into the chest without any hands. Take the left index finger, middle finger, and thumb. Take a toe lock on the left big toe and bring the left leg toward a 90-degree angle. Let the left shin and the left forearm be parallel. See if you can allow your hips to remain square to the short end of the mat. Extend the right arm long on the floor and just pause here. With the toe lock, you're not trying to pull the toe to the face, but it's as if you're trying to pull the toe out of the foot. Drop the belly and soften the chest as the front body drops into the back body. Put the left foot on the floor, anchor the left heel, point the left knee at the ceiling without the hands, draw the right knee into the chest with the index finger, middle finger, and thumb. Take the right big toe and come into half a happy baby pose. Extend the left arm towards the center of the room. Maybe the right elbow and the right knee touch each other and they support each other as you direct the right knee towards the right underarm. Try not to shorten your right side waist, but instead broaden your rear waistband. And just breathe easy. Just taking an inventory of the body. It's neither good nor bad. You're just trying to assess the weather of the body. Put the right foot on the floor. Put the hands on the chest just softly. Extend the legs to the ceiling. Suture the legs together. Cross the left ankle over the right ankle. Keep the legs sutured together. Bend the knees. Put the heels on the floor. Now slide the heels away from each other and the knees towards each other. You're just coming into reclined Sukhasana, left shin in front of right. See if you can get the heels under the knees. So it's simple cross-legged pose. Extend the arms up to the ceiling, palms face each other. Interlace the fingers together, palms face the chest. Draw the palms down towards the chest, turn the palms to the ceiling. Extend the arms up to the ceiling, and then inhale them overhead towards the wall behind you, maybe framing the head with the arms. Let the baby toe sides of the feet get heavy. Let the groins soften and the pelvic belly hollow. And pretend that you want to slide your side waist into the reach of the arms and into the palm of the hand. So we're just working in our hips and our shoulders. And we're trying to work on lengthening the lower back. Take the arms overhead. Use the hands, scoop the knees into the chest, and pause. Any way you like, come towards happy baby pose so that both shins are perpendicular to the earth and the forearms and the shins are parallel to each other. Heavy the sacrum, broaden the lower back. And this is a back body pose, so everything on your front body softens and sinks into the hammock of the back body. You might rock side to side a little bit. Just breathing easy. Like if it's very little effort, it's more of an intense awareness. Bring the inner knees together, extend the legs up to the ceiling. Bend the knees, put the feet flat on the floor with the heels close to the butt. Bring the bottoms of the feet together into what's called reclined Baddha Konasana or reclined cobbler's pose. Extend the arms back up to the ceiling. Interlace the fingers together again with the opposite index finger on top. Draw the palms to the chest. Turn the palms to the ceiling. Inhale the arms up to the ceiling, overhead to the back of the room, framing the head with the arms. Now, push the heels together, but try not to get hard in the inner thigh. Become heavier in the tailbone so you feel a gentle uplift in the lumbar spine. It's a bit of a back bend. And then from the breastbone to the pubic bone, the belly softens, the ribs soften, and the whole rib cage slides up into the reach of the arms to the palm of the hand. Terrific. Take the arms overhead. Scoop the knees into the chest. Extend the legs up towards the ceiling. Yeah. Put the right foot flat on the floor. Externally rotate the left thigh. Cross the left ankle over the right knee. Take the left hand. Create a mitten hand. And with the webbing between the thumb and the index finger, just externally rotate the left thigh. So you're creating a figure four. The right heel is anchored to the earth. The right knee is facing the ceiling. It's as if you're sitting in a chair. Like, imagine your back is in a chair and your buttocks is on the chair seat. Without the hands, draw the right knee in towards the chest. Then interlace the fingers behind the right knee. Draw the right knee a little closer, but use the left elbow to coax the left knee away. Try not to roll up on the lower back, but keep the waistband broad. So right knee comes in, left elbow to left knee, pushes left knee away, and we're just again in the hip a little bit. You might rock side to side, right? But the movement is small. I mean, there's just not a lot of movement to be found. Rolling up on the lower back takes us out of the hip, and that's what we're trying to find. Take the hand to the baby toe side of the left foot, just as it is. Put the right heel on the earth. And come again into half a happy baby pose. Now use some muscular effort to direct the left knee down towards the left underarm. You're not pulling. The left arm is straight. You're heavying the left shoulder, and it's that tension that's directing the knee down. Put the left foot on the floor. Extend the right leg up to the ceiling. Externally rotate the thigh. Cross the right ankle over the left knee. Create a figure four. With your right mitten hand, externally rotate the right thigh. It's like you're trying to open a jar, like a jar of honey or molasses. Without the hands, draw the left knee into the chest. Extend the arms between the figure four, and interlace the fingers behind the left knee. With the right elbow on the right knee, coax the right knee away as you draw the left knee in. And just pause. Maybe rock side to side, but not so much rolling up to the rear ribs. Keep everything as it is. Take the right hand to the baby toe side of the right foot. Put the left foot on the floor. Come to half a happy baby pose on the right hand side. Let the right arm be straight, but radically drop the right shoulder into the earth and direct the right knee to the right underarm. Put that foot on the floor. Extend the legs up to the ceiling. Cross the right ankle over the left ankle. Bring the heels to the butt. Bring the heels to the floor. Slide the heels away from each other. Get the heels underneath the knees and let the knees fall to the floor. Just recline Sukhasana on the other side. Extend the arms up to the ceiling, and this time bring the palms of the hands together. Interlace all the fingers together. Point the thumbs at the ceiling and point the elbow creases to your face. Now use some muscular strength and push the knees down, heavy the tail, lift the chest, inhale the arms overhead, framing the head with the arms. And just pause. The clasp is light. It's very light. If you can depress your tailbone more, lift your lumbar spine more, and feel a buoyancy in your chest, it'll help open the shoulders and extend the arms. Breathe easy. Maybe walk the knees left to right as if you were walking in place. Shimmy the left knee forward, then the right knee forward, and you're just walking in place. Working on hips and shoulders every day. Take the arms overhead, scoop the knees into the chest, and give yourself a hug. Put the feet on the floor, fish around for your yoga strap, which I think I brought with me, absolutely. You'll use a belt. Without the hands, draw the left knee into the chest and put the belt in front of the left heel. Take a strap tail in each hand and extend the left leg to the ceiling. Now keep the right knee bent for a minute. Anchor the right heel, direct the right knee to the ceiling. Extend the arms to the ceiling and put a strap tail in each hand, but hold on to the strap tail as if you were cupping a teacup. Now, the tension in the strap is not going to come from you pulling on the strap, but on you sinking your shoulders into the earth. Slide the right leg long. Slide the right heel away from the right hip, broaden the back of the right knee, and draw up powerfully on the right quad. Continue to sink the sacrum into the earth, and pretend that the left leg is like a pillar or a column that just reaches straight up towards the ceiling. The leg is fully extended. Don't allow the knee to bend, but fully extend the leg. Now take the strap into the left hand only and extend the right arm to the center of the room. Anchor your right side body by gathering your buttocks and extend the left leg towards the center of the room. Now think more about rolling the weight to your right side body. So engage the right leg, heavy the right buttock, and heavy the right shoulder. The left leg almost floats out of the body. Now lengthen the inseam of the left leg from underneath your right hip point. And breathe easy. Externally rotate the left thigh so the left toes and the left knee face the ceiling. Face the floor. The thigh externally rotates. Take the leg back towards 90 degrees. Place the strap in the right hand. Take the left thumb to the left hip crease and externally rotate the left thigh so that the outer left hip rolls to the inner right ankle, and take the leg across the body about 4 to 6 inches. Don't let the leg drop away from the face, but keep it almost parallel with the waistband as you come across the midline of the body. And again, you're searching for the outer left hip. And just pause, breathe easy. Become comfortable with any discomfort you might be feeling. Come back to neutral. Take the right leg up to meet the left, place a strap on the opposite heel. Strap tails in both hands, lower the left leg long. Just pause. Slide the left heel from the left hip. Suction cup the back of the left knee to the floor. The arms are straight. The leg is fully extended, but you're trying to drop your shoulders down into the mat. Take the strap tails both into the right hand now. Extend the left arm to the center of the room and extend the right leg away from the body. The right thigh externally rotates. Be in your left side body as the right leg floats away from the body. And pretend that you can lengthen the inseam of the right leg from underneath the left hip point. The hands are soft, the chest is soft. And you're breathing easy, right? You're working at about 50% capacity, but you've got 100% of your body dialed in. Bring the leg back towards 90 degrees. Take the strap into the opposite hand. Right thumb and right hip crease rolls the hip down. The thigh comes across the body. So it's as if you're wearing like a pencil skirt. You're trying to compact your hips. The thighs spiral in towards each other. So you're trying to become more narrow at the midline of the body. And then come back to neutral. Extend the left leg up to meet the right. So both legs are facing the ceiling. Put the strap to the side. Extend the arms up to the ceiling, palms face each other. Now, bring more weight to the tip of the tailbone and broaden your sacrum onto the earth. Drop the shoulders into the earth. Now become more aware of your stationary limbs rather than the limbs that move. Extend the right arm and the left leg in opposite directions. So said differently, the right leg and the left arm face the ceiling. Bring those limbs back together. Extend the right leg and the left arm in opposite directions. Bring those limbs to the floor. Bring those limbs back up. So right now the legs and the arms are facing the ceiling. And what you're doing is you're reaching the limbs away from each other, but on opposite sides of the body. So it's left leg, right arm to the floor, bring them up. Right leg, left arm to the floor, bring them up. It's as if you're walking in place. Left leg, right arm, bring them up. Right leg, left arm, bring them up. Go back and forth about two or three times as if you're walking in place. Pay attention to your stationary limbs. Gravity will help the other limbs. And you're just walking in place. Breathe easy. Nice. Let the arms and the legs face the ceiling. Draw the knees into the chest. Take your toe lock. Come to happy baby pose. Drop the knees, drop the shoulders, drop the belly, soften the chest. Nice. Bring the feet to the floor. Roll over and push up. We'll come to a flat tabletop position. I'm going to use a mat. I'm going to put it under my knees and my shins. I'm sorry, a blanket. Put it under my knees and my shins. And we'll just come to a flat tabletop position. Heels of the hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips. On an exhalation, tuck the tail, hollow the belly, put your chin on your chest, come to angry cat and pause. Dome the upper back. On an inhalation, lift your buttocks, lift your chest, lift your chin, but drop the gaze, purring cat. Exhale, slide back. Angry cat, pause. Broaden the shins, broaden the tops of the feet. Gather the sitting bones, hollow the belly. Inhale, slide forward. Lift the butt, lift the chest, lift the chin. Heavy the heel of the hand. Angry cat, purring cat, a couple of times any way you like. Let the motion originate in the pelvis. On the exhalation, slide back a little bit. On the inhalation, slide forward a little bit. On the exhalation, dome the upper back. The shoulder blades glide away from the midline of the body. On the inhalation, the shoulder blades slide down to the waistband. Pause in the center. Stay in the center and soften the right elbow. Bring the left shoulder to the left hip and look up and over the left shoulder back to your left pinky toe. Lengthen right side waist, shorten left side waist. Come to center. Soften left elbow. Bring right shoulder to right hip. Look up and over the right shoulder. Look at the outside of the right foot. Come to center. Bring the right hand towards the center of the mat. Bring the left hand behind the head. Now be gentle as you push down radically into the heel of the right hand. Come to a little bit of a gentle twist, but be more angry cat when doing it. Don't open the chest completely. Lift the head into the hand. Come back to center. Put the left hand where the right hand was. Bring the right hand behind the head. And think more about rolling your left ribs under the right ribs as the chest rolls open just a little bit. Come back to center. Extend the left leg straight back and be on the ball of the foot. Gaze forward 2 feet. Externally rotate the left thigh and put the left hand on the hip and pause. It's kind of like baby triangle or side plank. Pretend that the right thigh is like a column and the hips float over it. Extend the left arm up towards the ceiling. Turn the palm so it faces your ear. Take the arm overhead. Maybe the bicep comes to the cheek. Take the arm back up to the ceiling. Turn the palm so it faces the back of the room. Angry cat a little bit. And with the back of the left hand, swipe the right kidney and maybe get the right hip crease. With the left hand, if you hook the right hip crease, roll the outer right hip to the inner left ankle. Now drop your left shoulder down, lift your chest up, and look at the ceiling. Yep. Release the arm, swim it overhead. Right, we're gonna step back with the right foot. I'm just gonna change my orientation. Step back with the right foot, be on the ball of the right foot. Externally rotate the right thigh, put the right hand on the hip and pause. The top hip rolls over the bottom hip. And the left leg, the left thigh is like a column. Extend the right arm up, turn the palm so it faces the ear, bring the arm overhead, bicep to cheek. Kick the right heel back a little bit. Take the arm up, turn the palm so it faces the back of your body. Angry cat, with the back of the right hand, swipe the left kidney, maybe get the hip crease. Now purring cat, lift the chest. Drop the right shoulder behind the body, lift the chest more, and look towards the ceiling. And breathe easy. Terrific. Go ahead and unwind it all. Right. Come back to all fours. Now flip the toes of the feet so that all the toes are evenly spaced on the earth. Put the chin on the chest and slide the hips up and back so that you come to downward facing dog. And pause there. Bend the knees a little bit. Slide the hips up and back to where the wall meets the ceiling behind you. Keep the knees bent. Find the heel of the hand and the knuckle of the thumb, the index finger, and the middle finger, and depress them, but hollow the palm of the hand. Push into and off the floor as if you're pushing something away from yourself, and let the arms frame the head. Now resist the urge to go forward as you slide the buttocks up and back. Straighten the legs into a fuller expression of downward facing dog. The back of the heel descends. Now search for the big toe mound and the baby toe mound and broaden the front of the foot as you radically reach the toes out of the feet. Breathe easy. Spiral the thighs in towards each other so your pelvic belly narrows and directs itself towards your pubic bone. Bring the feet together at the back of the mat and suture the legs together. With the chin on the chest, just slide forward to plank pose and gaze forward about a foot. Dome the upper back. Don't allow the upper back to collapse, but keep pushing into and off the floor. Soften the knees, slide the hips up and back, downward facing dog. Bring the legs together at the back of the mat, suture them together. Pretend that you don't want the heels to come off the earth, but they do. As you slide forward, levitate forward, shoulders over wrists as you come towards plank pose. Palms of the hands are hollow. Upper back is domed. Soften the knees, slide the hips up and back. Downward facing dog. Now come up on the tippiest of tiptoes and then just walk the feet towards the face as you come to a standing forward fold. Yep. I forgot my blocks, so forgive me as I just come over here to the top of the studio and grab them. If you have blocks, try them. If you don't, find a shape that works for you. I'm going to put my blocks by the baby toe sides of my feet. and I'm going to perch up on spider fingers. Bend the knees a little bit, but draw up powerfully on your quads. Now back to the feet. The back of the heel descends. The big toe mound and the baby toe mound broaden. The toes radically extend. Start to straighten the legs any amount and roll the buttocks flesh up and over the waistband. So pretend that your pelvis is like a wheel and it's rolling forward. So the pubic bone depresses as you come to this standing forward fold. Nice. I'm going to take my blocks towards the top of the mat. And I'm going to bring the left foot forward. And I'm going to step back with the right foot into a left foot forward runner's lunge. Perched up on spider fingers, there's a buoyancy in the shape. You're not so deep that you can't move. Now just rock forward and backward a little bit. Keep the right leg fully extended. Keep the left knee radically bent. And just slide forward and backward a little bit. And what you're really looking to do is kind of open the front side of the right quad, right hip flexor, right psoas. Spring forward, standing forward fold. Don't slide back, but roll up and over. Step back with the opposite foot. Runner's lunge. Right knee's at a 90 degree angle. Left leg is fully extended. Slide forward and backward a little bit. Be buoyant. Feel like you're levitating. That's the eventual outcome of this whole thing. We levitate. Spring forward. Step back with the right foot. Runner's lunge. Left foot forward, runner's lunge. Now skip the right foot forward. It's up to you, about 4 to 6 inches, and put the right heel on the earth. So now the right heel's on the earth, and the right toes face the upper right-hand corner of the mat. Slide your buttocks up and back, and let that pull the left leg long as you come into this modified pyramid pose, or Parsvottanasana. Perch up on your finger pads, and lengthen the chest forward. It almost looks like purring cat. And be here now. The knees might be soft, but the quads are online. And as things start to settle in, you might drop forward. You might bring the left ribs towards the left thigh, right? You might tuck the head just a tiny little bit. Inhale, lift the chest and the chin. Exhale, step back to a fuller expression of a left foot forward runner's lunge. Radically lengthen the right leg. Spring forward, step back with the left foot, right foot forward runner's lunge. Start first by lengthening the left leg. Skip it forward 4 to 6 inches. Stand in the left heel and let the heaviness of the left heel pull the right leg long as you find yourself in this modified Parsvottanasana or pyramid pose. Take the right thumb to the right hip crease and roll the outer right hip to the inner left ankle. You want to try to get your waistband square to the short end of the mat and your pelvis level to any amount. Now the shape is owned by the back heel. Lift the chest, lift the chin, inhale up. Exhale, fold forward a tiny little bit. Maybe bring the right ribs to the right thigh. Maybe bring the right ear to the right inner shin. Pause. If you're feeling too much weight in the right leg, you got to work more diligently on the back leg. Energetically, the weight goes up and back. Bend the right knee to 90 degrees. Step back with the left leg. Come to a fuller expression of a right foot forward runner's lunge. And pause. Gaze forward. Spring forward. Fold forward.
Uttanasana, standing forward fold. Bend the knees so deeply the chest can easily come to the thighs. And then bring the fingers to your temples and the elbows to your knees. It's almost like you're thinking. Now, compact the hips, gather the sitting bones, hollow the belly. Don't straighten the legs, but push the feet down and start to lift the upper body. Stick the buttocks out, lift the chest and the chin, extend the arms to the ceiling. As you come to Utkatasana, a powerful pose, look up at the thumbs. Stand all the way up and pause. Awesome. Come to the middle of the mat. I'm going to put my blocks down right here. Let's come to Tadasana, mountain pose. I'll go through the whole thing. Have the feet about hips width apart. Let the arms just dangle at the side waist. The back of the heel descends down and into the earth. The front of the heel broadens. The big toe mound and the baby toe mound anchor to the earth. The front of the foot fans, and the toes radically extend to the front of the room. The arches of the feet lift, and the baby toe sides of the feet become broad. Now soften the knees just a little bit, it's unnoticeable, and draw up powerfully on your quads. Shrink wrap the musculature of your legs to the bone. Now gather your sitting bones, and as you gather your sitting bones, direct them into and up to the midline of the body. Find the tip of the tailbone and direct it towards the front of the heel. Pretend the horseshoe of your lowest front ribs and your lowest rear ribs float up and off the watery nature of your belly. Gently roll the shoulders up, back and down. Dial open the arms so that the elbow crease in the palm of the hand faces the front of the room. Now level the chin with the floor. Soften the gaze. Now pretend that your outer ears align with your outer ankles. Now become aware of the inner ankles, the inner thighs, the space between the pubic bone and the tailbone. Become aware of the front of the spine, trace it up to the roof of your mouth. Put the tip of the tongue on the roof of your mouth. Become aware of the crown of your head, the fontanelle, and pretend that the fontanelle floats over the perineum. Now be there. Find the center of the center of the center of the midline of the body, and pretend that your body, like a fine silk suit, hangs off of the midline. And we're going to be here for like a second or two. Become so centered, it feels like you're levitating. Nice. Bring the hands to the hips. Take the feet about 4 feet apart and kick the heels out a little bit and spiral the legs in a little bit so the back body becomes broad
and the front body becomes narrow. With your hands on your hips, take the index finger and the middle finger and depress the hip points as you spill forward to a wide angle forward fold, perching up on your finger pads. If the head will come to the floor, allow that to happen. But the buttocks doesn't slide back. The buttocks flesh rolls up and over the waistband. And the legs are on line evenly. Now, perch up on your finger pads, right? And gaze forward about a foot and deeply bend the right knee. Just deeply bend the right knee, but don't stick the buttock back. Straighten right leg, bend left knee. Don't stick the buttock back. Slide side to side. Fast, medium, or slow, it doesn't matter. You're just sliding side to side. If the outer hips slide over the outer ankles, great. Doesn't matter. Do not drop the chest and do not drop the chin. Slide back and forth any amount. The next time that you slide to the left, pivot on the ball of the right foot. Come to a left foot forward runner's lunge, lift the upper body, extend the arms overhead, Virabhadrasana 1. Slide the right leg back even more. Slide the left shins forward, the right heel back, lift the chest, lift the chin, gaze at the thumbs. Stick the buttocks out, put the ribs on the thigh, reach the arms forward, put the hands on the floor. Spin on the left heel, wide angle forward fold, slide forward and backward. Be buoyant, be fluid, fast, medium, or slow, it doesn't matter. The next time that the right knee starts to bend, pivot on the left foot, pivot on the right heel, right foot forward runner's lunge, lift the upper body, extend the arms overhead, Virabhadrasana 1. Lengthen radically through the left leg, slide the right shins forward, lift the chest, lift the chin. Put the right ribs on the right thigh, put the hands on the floor, spin on the right heel, slide forward and backward. Any amount. The next time that the left knee starts to bend, pivot on the ball of the right foot, spin on the left heel, put the hand on the baby toe side of the right foot, left foot, put the right heel on the earth, come to extended side angle. Now pause. Roll the weight to the baby toe side of the back foot. Let the left shin and the left forearm be parallel. Roll the chest open. Keep the upper body as it is. Don't lift the upper body. Pivot on the ball of the right foot. Close down. Wide angle forward fold. Slide side to side. Any speed, any amount, be fluid. Can you feel the whole body online? The next time the right leg bends, pivot on the ball of the back foot. Spin on the right heel. Put the right hand on the block or on the floor. And pause. Extend the arm. Extended side angle. Slide the right shins forward and the left heel back. And be here now. Occupy the whole body. Just drape yourself off the midline of the body. Yep. Close the shape. And this time, come to more of a static expression of your wide angle forward fold. If the head will come to the floor, let that happen. Cup the back of the Achilles. It's not quite resting. It's more thoughtful. Baby toe sides of the feet get heavy, the arches lift. The quads pull up, the buttocks rolls forward. Slide the fingers forward, lengthen the spine, gaze forward. Looks a little bit like purring cat. Spin on the ball of the right foot, spin on the left heel. Act as if you're coming back to side angle. Put the right hand on the right hip.
The shape is owned by this back leg. Now push the left heel down and forward and lift the upper body. Extend the arms parallel to the earth as you come to Virabhadrasana 2. Roll the shoulders up, back and down. Be fluid. Ma, ma, ma. Right, the legs are powerfully engaged and the upper body is like the sail of a ship. Roll the shoulders up, back and down and gaze out over the left middle finger. Now keep the anchoredness in the back heel, but reach, 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 reach. Bring the left hand to the block or to the floor. Swoop the arm up and overhead. Extended side angle. Lift the upper body. Straighten the left leg. Spin out on the right heel. Fold down. Swim the arm up. Virabhadrasana 2. On the other side. Right shin's forward. Left heel back. The upper body's buoyant. Right? There's a buoyancy. It's the legs. Boom. Right heel down and forward. Left heel down and back. Upper body. Easy. Look out over the right middle finger. Reach the right ribs out to the right thigh. Put the right hand on the block. Left arm overhead. Extended side angle. Breathe easy. Windmill the arms up. Starfish pose. Hands to hips. Fold forward. Head to the block or the floor or a blanket. Doesn't matter. Come to your forward fold. Slide the fingers forward, lengthen the spine. Come down to your knees. Yep. I'm going to sit on two blankets. Sit any way that makes you feel comfortable. Anytime you can elevate the hips higher than the knees, it makes the forward fold more accessible. I'm going to sit on two blankets. And if you have blocks, have them nearby. Extend your heels away from each other into about a 120-degree angle. The toes and the knees face the ceiling. Yep. If you're not using blocks, just slide your fingers forward. If you're using blocks, slide them forward. So you were just in a standing wide-angle forward fold. Now you're in a seated one. And the purpose of the standing shapes was to just bring your legs online. Now just consider this. The thighs dial open. The thighs spin away from each other so that the toes and the knees face the ceiling. Then what happens is the pubic bone burrows into the body. It slides back underneath the body and the buttocks flesh rolls up and over. And it's the actual rolling forward of the pelvis that projects the spine long, that brings you into the forward fold. Now perch up on your finger pads, lift the chest, lift the chin, and gaze forward. Rock side to side a little bit. Don't be so low that you can't reverse the shape. Slide the hands or the blocks back towards you. Now, if you're using a block, you'll put it on the inseam of the left leg. If you're not using a block, eventually your forearm will come to the shin. Take your right mitten hand, and with the webbing between the thumb and the index finger, put it in the right hip crease and depress the right thigh. Pretend the top of the right thigh bone drops down into the buttocks. Extend the left arm up. So it's right hand down, left arm up. Now pause. Legs are online. Thighs externally rotate. So reach up. Reach up. And then lengthen the left side waist over the left leg. Keep reaching. Don't crimp the spine, but lengthen the spine. And then eventually put the left hand either on the left forearm on the shin of the block, left hand on the foot. Take the right hand behind the head. Suction cup the back of the knees to the floor. Lift the chest, lift the chin, push the head into the hand. Now, reach the right elbow up and over the left leg, and then slide the right arm long. Radically lengthen your right side waist, but try not to crimp on the left side body. It'll happen, but you have to use the hand on the foot to drag. See how I'm dragging? Drag the chest long. Nice. Breathe easy. Try not to get hard in the top ribs. They need to be able to be like an accordion. Windmill up. Take the block to the opposite side if you're using it. Left mitten hand and left hip crease. Depress the thigh. Extend the arm. Radically lengthen the right side waist. You're trying to create like a J. You're reaching up and out of the body like the St. Louis Arch. Reach up, reach out, dive over the right leg. Keep reaching up and out. Take the right forearm to the block or the shin, the right hand to the foot. Take the left hand behind the head. Lift the chest, lift the chin, push the head into the hand. Keep dragging the right ribs over the right thigh. Now drag the left elbow over the right thigh. Now swing the left arm long. Pause. Let there be enough mobility in your upper body that you can move. Try not to close the chest, but instead roll the chest open. You're working on the back body. Broaden the kidney band. Lift the upper body. Pause. If you're using a block, take it. If not, you'll just interlace your fingers behind your head like this. I'm going to use the block. I'm going to put this other block out in front of me about 8 inches so that my breastbone or my belly comes to it. I'm going to take the block behind the head, or you're going to interlace your fingers behind your head. Yep. The purpose is you want to drop your head into your hands or push your head into the block. It'll bring you into a natural back bend. So depress the thighs. Slide or reach the side waist into the tip of the elbows. Lift the chest, lift the chin, drop the head into the hands, and start to roll forward, pointing the elbows towards the center of the room. Keep pointing, 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 pointing. Maybe the elbows come to the floor, and then maybe the head comes to the block. As you come into this final expression of your wide angle forward fold. And just pause. You can start to let go of the legs a little bit. And with the head on the block, you can let go of the upper back a little bit. Breathe easy. Yep. Slide the fingers back, lift the upper body. Now we want to take the legs offline. So lean back. Bring the soles of the feet together, Baddha Konasana, but let the heels be really far forward. If you've got a block or a blanket, you would put it under the shins because you want the inseam of the legs to come offline. You want to pretend that the inner thigh drapes down and off of the bone. Come forward any amount. Thumbs to the big toe mounds, fingers to the baby toe sides of the feet, and you're just rocking side to side. Now just watch. Take your hands like this and bring the hands together at your rear waistband. And you want to fan. You want to fan your lowest rear ribs and your kidney band out and into the reach of the legs. The legs begin on the back body. And just come forward and pause. Tuck the chin, but don't drop the head. Lean back, scoop the legs up. Lean back again and put the right shin in front of the left. And just rock side to side a little bit. Yep. Pause in the center.
I've been closing class chanting, so I'd like to chant tonight. You're welcome to join me if you'd like. I'm going to chant for peace associated with Kuan Yin, who is the patron saint of compassion and mercy. So I'll chant it once, give you an idea of the cadence, and then I'll chant it three times in a row, and then we'll just sit for maybe a couple, 2-3 minutes, occupying our body and following our breath. Take the back of the right hand, float it in front of the navel. I'm sorry, take the back of the left hand, float it in front of the navel, take the back of the right and put it in the palm of the left, and the thumbs naturally touch. It's the outcome. You don't have to make that happen. The baby toe sides of the feet become broad. The legs heavy. The legs coil up and underneath the body like a spring. And the spine naturally extends one vertebrae at a time up to and through the crown of the head. So I'll go ahead and chant once to give the cadence, and then three times in a row. You're welcome to join me. Om Shanti 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 Om. I'll chant three times. Om Shanti 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 Om. Om Shanti 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 Om. Om Shanti 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 Om. Gently lift the corners of your mouth, producing a discreet smile. Keep the hands where they are, just bring the palms together. Let the elbows be heavy and drip towards the earth, and float the hands together in front of your chest. Let there be space between the palms. Imagine the tip of the tailbone is like a taproot that descends down and into the earth, and the breastbone slides up and underneath the chin. Bring the chin to the chest. And imagine the mind like water pouring into the deep, vast pool of the heart. And as we surrender the head to the heart, imagine that the head and the hands become imbued with the characteristics of the heart, which might be love, empathy, and compassion. And it is those characteristics that motivate our thinking and our action. Thank you for inviting me into your home tonight. Thank you for allowing me the honor and privilege of participating in your practice. Namaste. Thank you, Jen. Enjoy the rest of your evening. And join us anytime you'd like. We'd love to have you. Have a great night. Bye-bye.